I said, Lord, if you want me to preach, I will. And that pressure that I was feeling on my heart, when I said I will, it lifted. It just lifted up. And I've never felt that again, that type of pressure upon my heart ever again. When I surrendered, when I said yes, that pressure relieved. My calling to preach, I would say, started as a teenager. Not necessarily so much the hearing the voice of God, but what I mean by that is I always felt a call on my life to be in leadership position, to lead. Leading among my friends. I remember I was in fifth grade. I ran for president of my fifth grade class. At church, I was youth group president, president over the youth ushers. In the band, I was a section leader and very much involved in band council because that's what my interest was when I was in high school. When I went to college, I was president of the gospel choir. So I've always found myself in leadership positions, and I always found myself being different from others in their thought process, or in thinking rather, being willing to stand on my own to think a different way and to act a different way. So I always knew that that was a part of my call. It had to be of God because God immediately began to start calling me. I began to understand what the call meant, what a calling on a person's life is. And I heard the voice of the Lord in my spiritual ear saying, I want you to preach. And I heard that. Now this is starting in May of 1994. And when I heard that, I felt a hand pressure over my heart, pressing down. I felt it. It was like a pressure on my heart. And at the same time, I heard in my ear, my spiritual ear, I want you to preach. So from called and accountable, I was involved in Bible study. Every Wednesday I was there, Sunday school I was there, and I kept hearing the voice of the Lord, I want you to preach. When Reverend Alexander was preaching, I heard that voice, I want you to preach. Pay attention to this scripture, you need to know this scripture. In Bible study, pay attention to this scripture, I want you to, this is what the Spirit is saying to me, I want you to note that scripture. In my own devotion, I felt the Spirit and heard the Spirit say, pay attention, did you catch that? And I was still hearing in my spiritual ear, I want you to preach. So I was hearing the spiritual call. And then there were three men that were very instrumental, because I believe that God uses people to help you in your call. So there were three men that were very instrumental in my calling. Number one was Walter Scott Thomas. He passed as New Psalmist in Baltimore, Maryland. He always came to University Park to do spring revival. And so all the members were like, oh man, Walter's coming, Walter's coming. You gotta hear Walter. So I was looking at his bio in church and I was reading his bio and he's an economics major. And so I'm experiencing the call of God and I'm looking at his major and he's an economics major and I was an economics major. And I'm asking myself the question, how did he go from economics to ministry? Because I'm hearing the voice of God calling me to preach. So at the service, I go back to the pastor's office and I say, hey, Dr. Thomas, how did you go from economics to ministry? And this was his response. He said, the call is all over your life. And I'm looking at him like dumbfounded, like, that's not what I asked you. And so he says, yeah. He said, the call is all over your life. Well, he never did answer my question about economics and ministry. That was number one. Number two, during the summer of that year, I walk into the pastor's study. Well, I walk into the church office because I was involved in ministry. I was always around University Park. I was just involved. So I walked into the church office, and Reverend Alexander was at the fax machine trying to get a paper jam out. And I walked in, I said, wow, the pastor got to do everything. And so he didn't even look up. He didn't even look up or turn around. He just said, yep, you'll be doing this one day. And I walked out the office like, what is he talking about? So that's two preachers that have affirmed my calling. And during this period of time, I told absolutely no one about my call to ministry. Absolutely no one. So that's two preachers that have affirmed my calling without me have said anything. The last one was in December of 94. I'm sitting at the kitchen table with my father. And my grandfather had just died. And my mother went on down to Spartanburg, South Carolina to be with my grandmother, her mother. So my dad, in our typical fashion, we were sitting at the kitchen table and we were having breakfast. And we were sitting there about an hour just talking. And out of the blue, he says, when are you going to accept your calling? It's like, what? He was like, when are you going to accept your calling? So I broke down and began to tell him everything that I have been experiencing as it relates to the call. And so all of this whole time, I'm hearing the voice of the Lord saying, I want you to preach. This whole time I'm experiencing that pressure upon my heart, like as a force, I'm like a hand forcing down upon my heart. I felt that. And I've had three ministers that, particularly Claude Alexander, who was my pastor, Walter Thomas, who was and is a great preacher, and now my dad, my spiritual father and father, have all confirmed my calling without me saying anything to them. So I go back to Charlotte. And I remember getting down on my knees in my one bedroom apartment. And I said, Lord, if you want me to preach, I will. And that pressure that I was feeling on my heart, when I said, I will, it lifted. It just lifted up. And I've never felt that again, that type of pressure upon my heart ever again. When I surrendered, when I said yes, that pressure relieved. So my father and I had sat down and said, well, we'll go ahead and begin to prepare for your trial sermon, and we'll prepare for when you would do that and when we make the announcement. So in March of 1995, I come home. Just on a random come home. I'm sitting in church in the back like I normally do. And my dad, he can't keep water. And so he announces, he says, I want to tell the church something. He said, I want to let you all know that Jamale has acknowledged his call to ministry. He's going to preach. And the church erupted in a glorious hallelujah mystical cloud, and I was like, wow. So this is the fourth confirmation that God wanted me to preach, when your home church affirms you in such a way. So I talked to Reverend Alexander, let him know that God had called me to preach. And he said the exact same thing. He said, well, we're going to wait and we're going to hold it. We're not going to tell the church just yet. So one Sunday morning, he does the exact same thing. He says, church, I want to tell y'all something. University Park is a much larger church. And I was actively involved in ministry. So I knew people and I knew the church. He says, I want to announce to y'all that Jamale has announced and acknowledged his call to ministry. The same thing happened. The church erupted in applause and praise. Now this is five affirmations that God had wanted me to preach. So it's something that when your home, when your church affirms this about you. And so that's my calling to ministry. And when I finished the graduate program at UNC Charlotte that I was in, I went directly to seminary at Southeastern Baptist Theological Seminary in Wake Forest.
Looking for some inspirational gospel content? Just subscribe to Brother Rollins' YouTube channel today. We post the most motivational and preaching videos and gospel songs that are sure to get you through any situation. Even better, we have also launched a new apparel store that gives you access to a wide range of high-quality items. From awesome tees to hoodies, sweatshirts, mugs, and even tote bags, you can now proclaim your faith wherever you go and support our YouTube channel. Just visit the Brother Rollins YouTube channel and click on the store tab to shop now.